right?
I decided I'd go up to Hardknott Pass this evening because we've got a bit of time, so I've dropped my bags and everything off at the Brown Cow Inn where I'm staying, and I'm heading out. It's half an hour out there, and obviously it'd be half an hour back, but I'm going to have a ride up to Hardknott Pass, which is what I was intending to do tomorrow, but I can probably still do it tomorrow, but might as well go out and take advantage of it. So I've got me flask of coffee and a lovely cherry lattice pastry, and I'm gonna go and go up Hardknott Pass, see what it's like, and I'm looking forward to the sunset tonight. The guy was saying, the landlord of the Brown Cow was saying that the sunset is absolutely fantastic over the Irish Sea from the beer garden tonight, so that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Sit in the beer garden tonight and have a beer and watch the sunset. And in the meantime, we're gonna get in some extra scenery while we've got the hours, because tomorrow I'll start early tomorrow. I'll leave about 9 o'clock, probably after breakfast, have breakfast half seven. Woo, round the corner. I thought I dropped two gears there, but it didn't do. It just did one, right, so down to fourth, down into third. We're in standard mode. So maybe we'll put it into sports. And she's in sports mode. Now, around the corner. It looks a bit wet up there, actually, up the top, doesn't it? But we're going to go for it. Might be wet tomorrow and then I would have missed it, so I'm gonna go tonight. Here we go, take a right here. Cool, we run.
We're on right off farm tracks here, aren't we? But it goes all the way up along parallel to the river. It looks damp up there, look. It might not be, but it looks damp to me. Misty-ish. Raining, maybe. But I've got waterproof top. And we're alongside the river, look. And that's tidal as well, look. You can't see that's tidal. I reckon that's tidal. View, isn't it? Look at this. Steady as she goes, because a narrow one, you know, single lane with lots of gravel in the middle of it as well. So we're just going to go slow and steady. All the old sheep, chocolate coloured ones. nice to be up the lakes, I think. I don't think many people go this route for the Hardknott Pass. They probably take the main, more of the main route. But I like the look of this. It's called Birkby Road. Birkby Road. Those fells look gorgeous. They don't look far away, will they? Not far away at all. They look so walkable. Except I'm here to ride in the lakes, not walk in the lakes. Ew. Wow, they got their own little lake stroke pond. There's an old phone box. So we're half a mile from the Roman camp. This is the hilly bit now. I'll let these people get ahead because I don't want to stop on the hill because they can't drive. A bit juddery, the old road. The tarmac's nearly non-existent, but you know, this is what it is. And look at that. Don't need me visor down for this. That view. When we get up at the Roman camp, I think I'm going to stop, have me cup of coffee, and put it in it first. Just as well I've got my anti-vibration on the telephone, because it's pretty bumpy this tarmac. And we're gaining in height because I felt my ears pop. Look at that. That looks so unreal, the grass, the colour of the grasses. Look at that, wow. Dead ahead. Thank you. Wow, this is steep and rough and potholy. I'm glad that woman kindly waited to let me up. Cyclists, slow down. They shouldn't be up here. Not really. Look at the views. Fantastic. Beautiful views. Wow, look how steep this is. Crazy, crazy steep. sheep. Wow. Now, wide. Back brake. Look at that. That is crazy steep. Wow, I reckon I've done the hardest one first. The old sheep. Some seriously big holes in this road though. Not a problem for the dirt bike. Sheep on the road. They don't chase you like the dogs do. Thank you. Langsdale. Right, it's not pass. Let's go for it. Right. another road over there, look through there. Bellfoot Farm. Thank you. Seems clear from your side, right?